What do the numbers 210, 720, 175,560, and 17,297,280 all have in common? Now, if you answered that they all end in zero, you would be correct, but more importantly, they are the only known numbers that can be factored into consecutive integers without any overlap, meaning we would throw out the number 5040, because that can be achieved by multiplying 720 by 7 to both factorizations. This, of course, begs the question, are there more of these? And if so, how can we find them? While I do not have an answer, I hope to show through this problem why number theory is hard. Oh hey, that's the name of this. Since this question asks about factoring, we have to start with the fundamentals of arithmetic. And look, here's the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, which states that every integer greater than 1 can be uniquely represented as a product of primes. The original ideas of the proof date back to Euclid's Elements, if anyone has a desire to know precisely why this is true. What this gives us is a new way to represent numbers in what I am calling factor space, a high-dimensional semi-module where each prime is given a dimension of its own. We can represent the natural numbers using lists of prime powers. For example, 210 is a factor of 2, 3, 5, and 7, and so gets a 1 in each of those entries. Visually, these can be thought of as arrows or vectors pointing in the space. As such, we denote the members of the space with arrows over the number which it represents. In this space, we have two key operations, addition and scaling. To add two of these arrows, we simply add the components, and what results is the product of the original two arrows. For example, if we take the 2 vector and the 3 vector and add each component of the vectors to each other, we get a vector that corresponds to the number 6, the product of 2 and 3. We note that the 1 vector does not affect addition, which corresponds to the fact that we can normally multiply by 1 and not change the result. To scale a vector, we multiply each component by the desired scalar, which produces a vector exponentiated by that scalar, as we see in the 4 example. Geometrically, this behavior can be described by these pictures, where vector addition produces the vector as the far corner of the parallelogram whose edges are the summons. We can scale vectors by changing the length without changing the direction of a particular vector. This structure is quite useful in a number of ways. For example, we can find the least common multiple and greatest common divisor of two numbers by considering their vector form and creating a new vector with the large and small components respectively, as we see in this example. This also produces a trivial proof of the fact that a least common multiple multiplied by the greatest common divisor produces the product of the original two numbers. This comes out of the fact that these two operations shuffle the information in a reversible manner. Those familiar with linear algebra might see this as a change of basis. One reason I speak of these operations in particular is that the greatest common divisor can reveal if two numbers are coprime, which is the geometric meaning of perpendicular arrows in the factor space. And we care about perpendicular vectors because many of the important maps we care about in number theory are the multiplicative functions, which allow for the addition of perpendicular vectors to be preserved through its application. These are not relevant for our discussion, but these include the Euler-Totient function, the Möbius function, the divisor functions, and Ramanujan's tau function. Structure-preserving maps like this are very nice, and if we lose this structure-preserving element, we very quickly get lost in the abyss. Perhaps the simplest map that does not respect this structure is the successor function, which simply adds 1 to the original number. By adding 1, we completely change the factorization each time, resulting in this mess of a map, as we see by applying it to the integers 1 through 10. S does a really good job at scrambling our vectors. By taking a difference of squares, we can arrive at this very strange formula for 2s. Fortunately, even this is still a little useful. We know that a number and its successor are coprime, meaning that anything that divides the original number can no longer divide its successor, which means that S always moves a vector to a perpendicular subspace. It also tells us that we can always produce new prime numbers by applying S to a product of known primes, which must exist in a new frontier of primes. That formula of the infinitude of primes shows itself like this. In that, we sum up the vectors of a list of prime numbers, apply the successor, and get a weighted sum of different prime numbers out of this operation. A number of interesting problems can be expressed in this notation, such as the twin prime conjecture, which states that there are an infinite number of primes whose difference between them is 2. But now we get back to our motivating problem, the products of consecutive integers, which we have expressed in the natural notation. In the notation of the factor space, it asks what happens when we sum over several iterations of the successor function, which can be thought of as a walk-through factor space. Number theorists have determined what happens in particular cases, such as when m is equal to 2 or m is equal to 2n, but no general solutions exist. The existence of solutions to this problem will need to balance with the high dimensionality of factor space and the length of walks taken. An example of this can be seen by considering the product of 19 through 54 being equal to the product of 23 through 57. This works mostly because of the high degree of overlap built off of a known reduced solution. Do I think there are more solutions? Maybe, but we probably do not have the computational power to find this without some radically new methods. My challenge for you in this video is that you provide additional formulae and proofs in this factor space framework in the comments. Excellent examples will receive shoutouts in a future video. And while you do that, make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.